Hi friends, welcome back to CSS Zero to Hero. This series is for beginners who wants to learn CSS. In this video, I'm going to talk about two other important properties, margin and padding in CSS. Let's start. In the last video, I have explained about borders, and margins are used to create space around elements outside of any defined borders. Let me use our previous example. We can see our content is in the top left corner. But still, we are able to see some spacing here. This is because of the browser style sheet. Every browser maintains its own style sheet and have some default values. In case, if you are not specifying values for any property, it will take the default value from the browser. If I inspect and go to Computer tab, we can see this browser is maintaining a default margin of 8 pixels in each sides of body element. So let me give margin top 0 pixel and margin left 0 pixel. Now if I refresh, our content is moved to the extreme top left. There is no spacing. And for our box div, let me give a margin left of 20 pixel. Now we can see our content is moved 20 pixel towards right. Similarly, let me add a top margin of 30 pixel. Now if I refresh, we can see our content is moved down. If I add a margin bottom or margin right, we will not see any changes. But if we have more contents on the right side and bottom, we can see the difference. Okay, now we have added margin to all four sides. Let's get into the shorthand property. Instead of giving all these properties separately, we can use the shorthand property margin. In this, we can pass four values. First one is margin top. Let me give 100 pixel. Second one is margin right. Let me give 20 pixel. Third one is margin bottom. For that, let me give 30 pixel. And the last one is margin left. Let me give 50 pixel. So if I refresh and if I inspect, we can understand from this image, we can see 100 in the top, 20 in the right, 30 in the bottom, and 50 in the left. Okay, instead of giving all four properties, we can also give two properties. When we give two, it will consider the top and bottom values as the first value and left and right values as the second value. Let me give 40 pixel and 80 pixel. Now if I refresh, we can see top and bottom values are 40 pixel and left and right values are 80 pixel. I can also give one value. In that case, all sides will be having the same margin. Let me give margin 50 pixel. Now if I refresh, we can see 50 pixel margin in all four sides. And we can also give three values. In that case, first value will be the top value, second value will be taken into left and right, and the third value will be the bottom value. Let me show that. I am going to give 10 pixel, 20 pixel and 30 pixel. We can see both left and right are having 20 pixel. Top is 10 pixel and bottom is 30 pixel. And there is a concept called margin collapsing. If you like to know more about that, you can see this video on margin collapsing. The link is also in the description. This is all about margin. Now let's move to padding. Padding is used to create space around an element's content inside of any defined borders. Let me add a padding top so that we can understand. Now we can see a space between the top border and the actual content. Similarly, let me add some padding in the right, bottom, and left. Now we can see this. The shorthand properties behave similar to that of margin. So in case you want to specify equal padding to all four sides, you can simply give one value like this. So we can see this. And before we close, I want to show you one more difference between margin and padding. For margin, we can use negative values, but for padding, we cannot use negative values. Let me show that. First, let me comment this and give 20 pixel margin to all four sides. Now let me refresh and target this element in the inspect window. Okay, I'm going to reduce the margin value. We can see the margin is getting reduced. When it reaches 0, it is in the extreme top left of the window. And if I further reduce, we can see the content is moving out of the window. Let me try the same with respect to padding. When I reduce the padding, we can see the space between the border and the actual content is getting reduced. When it reaches 0, we couldn't see any space between the border and the actual content. If I reduce further, we cannot see any change. And so we can understand padding is not accepting negative values. Even here, it is throwing error. Invalid property value. Hope you understood. See you in my next video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.